and his name, and save us from all evil.
Thank you. which are crazy. The joy will be in my land and my name, and in my name will I lift up my hands. As the marrow of Matins, the Epistle will be filled, and with lips rejoicing shall my mouth praise thee. If I remember thee on my bed, and the one I meditate on me, for thou art become my helper. The shelter of thy wings will I rejoice. The soul will cleave unto thee, and my right hand is good to hold me. Thus for thee in vain have it brought after my soul. It shall go into the nethermost parts of the earth. It shall be surrendered unto the end of the sword. Horses for foxes shall they be. The heathen shall be glad in God. Every one shall be praised as sore offender. For the mouth of them is death, to speak unjust things. At the dawn I meditated on thee, thou art become my helper. In the shoulder of thy wings will I rejoice. My soul hath pleased unto thee, thy right hand is good to help me.
Always
with
love, praise the sensible Holy Spirit, and joy and glory and patience and angels. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
I stretched forth my hands unto thee. My soul thirsted after thee like a watery stream.
not thy face away from me, as I give my unto them that will give unto me. Cause me to hear thy mercy in the morning, for I gave how I put my foot. Cause me to know, O Lord, the way where I now should walk, for unto thee I lifted up my soul. Rescue me from my enemies, O Lord, unto thee I have fled from refuge. Teach me to do thy will, for thou art my God. Thy good spirit shall lead me in the land of brightness, for thy name, save the Lord, shall not be in me. In thy righteousness shall thou bring my soul out of affliction, and in thy mercy shalt thou utterly destroy my enemies. And thou shalt cut off all that benefit to my soul, for I am thy servant. O Lord, give ear unto my supplication, and enter not into judgment with thy servant. O Lord, give ear unto my supplication, and enter not into judgment with thy servant. Thy good spirit shall lead me in the land of brightness. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to ages and ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to the Lord. Alleluia, 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 glory to the Lord. Alleluia, 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 glory to the Lord. For our God and the Lord, glory to the Lord.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Mercy.
One peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, for the peace of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for those who with faith, reverence, and fear of God enter therein, for our Father, Metropolitan Joseph, for the venerable priests of the Diaconate Christ, for the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Metropolitan Paul, Archbishop John, instead of quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the President of the United States and all civil authorities and for our armed forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Ronnie, Andrew, Joshua, Madison, Cecil, Benjamin, Thaddeus, Adam, and Skyler, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city and for every city and land and for the faithful who dwell therein, for health, seeds, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and their salvation, for those under persecution, for the faith, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Find to remembrance of all holy Immaculate, most blessed, and glorious, and ever of all souls, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other in all our life unto Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
For unto thee are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Let us dance in the fire in the name of the Lord. mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy mercy. Calling to remembrance our all holy immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theodosia, O Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Have mercy.
Calling to remembrance our all holy immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
For blessing is thy name, and glorified is thy kingdom, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Observe all that I have commanded you, and lo, I am
watching out away from thy presence, and with now thy holy spirit for me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, with thy governing spirit establish me. I shall teach them treasures thy ways, and the ungodly shall turn back to me. The Lord be who blood those things of God, the God of my salvation. The sun shall rejoice in thy righteousness, O Lord, that shall look my lips, and my mouth shall declare thy praise. For thou hast desired sacrifice and equipment, the former and offering which shall not be pleased. A sacrifice unto God is a broken spirit, a heart that is broken and humble, God will not despise. To go to the Lord, and I'll be a pleasure and desire, and with the walls of Jerusalem be built up. Then shall thou be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness, with which we hold our offerings, and shall they offer bullets upon thy altar.
Of the honorable glorious prophet, forerunner, and Baptist John, of the holy glorious all honorable apostles, Peter and Paul, and of all the holy apostles, of our fathers among the saints, great hierarchs and ecumenical teachers, Basil the great, Gregory the theologian, and John Chrysostom, Athanasius Cyril, and John the merciful, patriarchs Alexandria, Nicholas and Myra, spirit of Prometheus, and Nectarius of the Tepus, the wonder workers, of our fathers and mother saints, Chikan, patriarch of Moscow, and Raphael, bishop of Brooklyn, of the holy glorious great martyrs, George the trophy bearer, Demetrius the murder screamer, Theodore the soldier, Theodore the general, and Venus the wonder worker, of the higher martyrs, Ignatius, the god bearer of Antioch, Aralambos, and Eleutherios, of the holy, glorious, great women, martyrs, Thecla, Barbara, Anastasia, Catherine, Chiriaki, Protein, Marina, Paris, Eva, and Irene, of the holy, glorious, right, victorious martyrs of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, who shone in the ascetic life of Saint Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of our venerable and God-bearing Father Euthymios the Great, and new martyr Zachariah of Maria, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all the saints, we beseech thee, O most merciful Lord, hearken unto the petitions of us sinners, who make our supplications unto thee in that mercy. Upon us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy upon us and save us.
Thou it is in Christ, who granted resurrection to death. God will grant you a sign that will bring joy to the churches, that he can meet those needs of good cheer. From his youth, he lived a life of asceticism, eventually settling in the barren desert between Jerusalem and Jericho. He filled his days with night and nights with prayer, internal thought, contemplation, and physical exertion. And there were many disciples gathered, some of whom were glorious saints, such as Sabbath was sanctified. God gave Nicodemus to expel demons, healed and raised the ill, bring water to the desert, multiplied bread and prophesied. When some of the younger monks wanted to fast more than others, he forbade them and commanded them to come to the communal table so they would not become prideful. He also taught monks not to move from place to place. A tree frequently transplanted does not bear fruit. Whoever desires to do good can do it from the place where he sits. Eugenius reposed peacefully at age 97 in 473. On this day, we also commemorate the newborn Zachariah of Maria. By your intercessions, O Christ God, have mercy upon us. Amen.
The Son of old has roared, the devil is helpless, begetting kind.
Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remembrance our all holy Master's most blessed and glorious name, so most holy and virgin Mary's. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy upon us and save us.
O Lord.
Holy is the Lord our God. Holy is our God. Thank you.
of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for those who with faith, reverence, and fear of God enter therein, for our Father and Metropolitan Joseph, for the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Metropolitan Paul, Archbishop John, and for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the President of the United States and all civil authorities and armed forces in America, especially for Peter, Ronnie, Andrew, Joshua, Madison, Cecil, Benjamin, Thaddeus, Adam, and Skyler, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city and for every city and land and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Suffering for captives and their salvation, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remembrance, O Holy Immaculate, most blessed and glorious, Lady, Mother of all souls, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves, each other, and all life unto Christ our God.
Amen.
Thank you. Brethren, it is the God who said, "Let light shine out of darkness," who has shown in our hearts to give the light of knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Christ. But we have this treasure in earthen vessels to show that the transcendent power belongs to God and not to us. We are afflicted in every way, but not crushed, perplexed, but not driven to despair, persecuted, but not forsaken, struck down, but not destroyed, always carrying the body of the death of Jesus, so that the light of Jesus may be manifest in our bodies. For while we live, we are always being given up to death for Jesus' sake, so that the light of Jesus may be manifest in our mortal flesh. So death is at work in us, but life in you. Since we have the same faith, spirit of faith as he had who wrote, "I believed and so I spoke," we too believed and so we speak, knowing that he who raised the Lord Jesus will raise us also with Jesus and bring us with you in his presence. For it is all for your sake, so that as grace extends to more and more people, it may increase thanksgiving to the glory of God.
Peace be to thee that readeth. Wisdom, stand upright. Let us hear the holy gospel. Peace be to all.
The reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to thee, O Lord. Glory to thee, O Lord.
Let us be attentive.
At that time, as Jesus entered a village, he was met by 10 lepers who stood at a distance and lifted up their voices and said, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." When Jesus saw them, he said to them, "Go and show yourselves to the priests." And as they went, they were cleansed. Then one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, praising God with a loud voice, and fell on his face at Jesus' feet, giving him thanks. Now he was a Samaritan. Then said Jesus, "Were not 10 cleansed? Where are the 9? Was no one found to return and give praise to God except this foreigner?" And Jesus said to him, "Rise and go your way. Your faith has made you well."
Completely healthy. A miracle. 9 of those continued with no apparent reaction. Now isn't that amazing? Only one, only the Samaritan, stopped, and praising God with a loud voice, hurried back to Jesus and fell at his feet to give thanks. The rest, maybe anxious to get back to living a normal life, didn't even slow down. They just kept going. Drawing attention to their ingratitude, Jesus asked aloud, was no one found to return and give praise to God except this foreigner? I'm certain that Jesus was not surprised by the lack of thanksgiving on the part of his own people. After all, he had had to deal with this for centuries upon centuries. But he was still greatly dismayed by it. For thanklessness is a sickness far worse than leprosy or anything else. It is a deep sickness of the soul that even God cannot cure. We almost have to ask ourselves, what kind or what sort of psychology is at work that allows someone who is stricken with a horrible disease, terrible, painful, to be healed and not even think to show gratitude? What, that's, you know, is that normal? There's something wrong there for sure. Notice that Jesus didn't praise the Samaritan who gave thanks, but he pointed out the 9 who didn't. That was the unusual part. Giving thanks would be normal. It was those other guys that were a bit, well, off. And if I were to describe their response, their action, in the modern vernacular, I think I might use the word entitlement. Did not those 9 men show gratitude to God because they felt entitled to their cure? You know, this is finally justice for me. Finally, I'm cured. At the very least, they felt entitled to live a normal, healthy life and enjoy all the good things that everybody else enjoyed. They felt cheated by their disease, and once that was taken care of, okay, all right. You know, now things are the way they should be. Perhaps they saw their disease as something that they did not deserve to have inflicted on them. Have you noticed that when something bad happens to a person, you know, he will often question God. Why is God doing this to him? I thought God was merciful. I thought God loved me. You know, and that whole idea is that I deserve better treatment from God. Would you call that entitlement? I think that comes pretty close. A person can develop a deep resentment over whatever bad things happen to him. And should such things be resolved, should a miracle happen and your leprosy is cured, well, there's seldom thanksgiving. Thanks given. But more like, you know, it's about time. So okay. We have a whole list of things that we think we are entitled to. Entitled to. Not just that we would like to have. We think they belong to us. Life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, perhaps. Mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon, and remission of sins, perhaps. Live long and prosper, perhaps. And the truth is, I mean, the reality is, we are not entitled to any of these things in this fallen world. Not even life. Not anything. Life doesn't owe you a thing. We have no entitlements. We deserve nothing or any good thing in this world. But we think we do. In fact, we insist we do. We can't imagine that we don't. And the funny thing is, the more good that we receive, the more we think we deserve. This is the source of our selfish thanklessness in life. A sense of entitlement drives us to set God aside, not only in the giving of thanks, but in the blind pursuit of whatever it is that we feel we deserve. Can't tithe, sorry, saving for a house in the country. It's mine, it's my right. Can't come to church, I'm too busy with school or work or family. I can't fast, I'm training for the Olympics.
Whatever. You know, God is not convenient when we are entitled to live a good life. Furthermore, this attitude does not disappear, even if we should gain the very things that we want. Once that attitude that we are due certain good things in this world has settled into our soul, it remains there, rendering us useless to God. Useless. It is the polar opposite of taking up your cross and denying yourself and following Christ. So in light of today's gospel, we should consider how much this attitude of entitlement might reside in us. Not if, but how much. In the world, focus is always on personal rights and what is due to us. But this has no place in the Christian life. You are owed nothing. The Christian is completely without rights or entitlements of any sort. Now we must always treat others as having rights, as being entitled to mercy, love, and our compassion and our giving, to put their needs above our own. But we must consider ourselves as being undeserving of any good thing. The roof fell in on that one. And why? Why am I saying this? Why should the Christian consider themselves without rights? Because, you know, have you forgotten? We are slaves. We are bondservants of the Lord. Slaves have no rights except what their good master bestows upon them. And whatever good that we have, that we enjoy in this life, and actually we enjoy quite a bit of good, is from the hand of the God who loves us and shows mercy upon us and bestows us good things in this life as promises of the good things to come. And I think this is the proper attitude to cultivate. But be warned that it does come at a cost. When you decide to live as a true servant of God, a slave of God, you must give up your own willfulness and your sense of self-determination in life. I think some of us couldn't even imagine how to live that way. We're not directed by what we want and our own purpose, our own desires. But you no longer belong to yourself, but to God. You no longer can live as you please, but must now serve the will of your master. Can you do this? Or does that idea offend your sense of independence? That's a legitimate question. If you can, if you think you can, if you think, yeah, you know, I sort of forgot, didn't I, that being a Christian is like being the bond servant of the Lord. And I got a little too willful, I got a little too careless, but I want to get back to that. If I can do that, well, you will lose other things. I mean, it doesn't stop there. The list keeps growing. You will lose fear, hopelessness, and dissatisfaction in life, and the fear of death. See, once you realize you are a servant of God, what you have or have not does not matter, as long as you have the love of God. You will lose all existential angst, if that sort of thing bothers you, for your life will have a new and rich and eternal meaning and purpose as the servant of God. You no longer try to find your way based on what desires want to be satisfied. Instead, you are serving God, the true and living God. You will lose grumbling and complaining and the persistent sense that there should be more for you. Life is holding back. No. You will lose ingratitude and thanklessness, and you will gain the deepest possible human joy. To serve God in gratitude is in fact the highest human calling. And we often choose less, but God still offers us more. Let us learn to be grateful that we, the unworthy, are given such a wonderful and undeserved gift to the glory of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace, wisdom,
and guarded always up by thy might. Ascribe glory unto thee, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of the age.
Lord God, remember all of us in your kingdom, always, now, and ever, and to ages of ages. Amen.
to remembrance are all the holy, immaculate, most blessed, and glory, and great, thanks, O Lord, and your Virgin Mary. Well, all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Cease to do all things until love has brought us back stand beside you thousands of archangels and now thousands of angels, the cherubim and the seraphim, six winged, many eyes soaring along, borne on their pinions, singing the triumphal hymn, shouting, proclaiming, and saying,
thank you. Thank you.
must make just a brief reminder that we may only serve this blessed sacrament to those who are chrismated members of the Eastern Orthodox Church in good standing.
With the fear of God and faith and love, draw near.
Thank you. grace.
O God, save thy people and bless thine inheritance.
Worthily give thanks unto the Lord.
Lord, have
save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Asking that the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Sanctify those who love the beauty of thy house. Glorify them and recompense by thy divine power. And forsake us not in hope on thee. Give peace to thy world, to thy churches, to the priests, to all civil authorities, to our armed forces, and to all thy people. For every good and perfect gift is from above and cometh down from thee, the Father of lights. Unto thee we ascribe glory, thanksgiving, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Lord, have mercy.
hast trampled down death and made powerless the devil and given life to thy world. Do thou the same, Lord, give rest to the soul of thy departed servant, the priest Ibrahim, in a place of brightness, place of virtue, place of repose, whence all sickness, sorrow, and sighing have fled away. Pardon every sin which he hath committed, whether by word or deed or thought, for thou art good and lovest mankind. For there is no man who liveth and sinneth not, that thou only art without sin, and thy righteousness is to all eternity, and thy law is truth. For thou art the resurrection and the life, and the repose of thy departed servant, O Christ our God, and unto thee be ascribed glory, together with thy Father, who is from everlasting, and that all holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Venerable brother, who art worthy of blessedness and memory eternal. Whose divine liturgy we have now celebrated, of the holy, glorious, and right victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, of Saint Barnabas, patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of the venerable and God-bearing father, Euthymios the Great, the new martyr, Zachariah of Morea, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all the saints, have mercy for us and save us, for as much as he is good, love us mankind. Prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Amen.
We're actually doing two memorial services this Sunday, so sorry for the confusion, if there was. But the first one we just did within the liturgy was for a priest, local priest, Father Ibrahim Johan. Who had recently passed just this week, I believe. And so the Metropolitan has asked all of us, all of the churches, to pray for him for 40 days. And then now we do a regular monthly memorial for Orthodox and non-Orthodox friends and relatives who have departed
sometime during the month, a month of January. Blessed is our God, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Now and ever and unto ages, amen. All Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, cleanse us from our sins. Master, pardon our iniquities. Holy God, visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Now and ever and unto ages, amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Now and ever and unto ages of ages.
The mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, and remission of their sins, Let us ask of Christ, our immortal King and our God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O God of spirits and of all flesh, who hast trampled down death and made powerless the devil and given life to thy world, do thou, the same Lord, give rest to the soul of thy departed servants, Father Ibrahim, the priest Ibrahim, Victoria Ariam, Truman, Belma, George, Larry, Katrina, Joyce, Vicky, Clifford, Anil, Chester, Alice, Anil, Ron, Tatiana, Christina, Asamina, Wola, Paul, Bob, Raymond, Ruben, Hope, Dina, Constantine, Irina, Dini, Amin, for Dorothy, Cheryl, Charlie, Kenneth, Theodore, Nikolai, Klein, Todd, George, Elisiel, Clifford, Maria, Lucia, Norman, Thomas, Donna, and Bill. In a place of brightness, a place of repose, a place of virtue, whence all sickness, sorrow, and sighing have fled away. Pardon every sin which they have committed, whether by word or deed or thought, for thou art good and lovest mankind. For there is no man who liveth and sinneth not, and thou only art without sin, and thy righteousness is to all eternity, and thy law is true. For thou art the resurrection and the life, and the repose of thy departed servants, O Christ our God, and unto thee we ascribe glory, together with thy fathers from everlasting, and thine all holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Save us.